As the middle school graduation comes to an end, Rentarou Aijou musters all of his courage to finally confess his feelings to Asakawa. To his surprise, the girl reciprocates, admitting she likes him too, but swiftly adds that the idea of dating him makes her want to puke. Down on his luck after suffering his 100th rejection, Rentarou seeks solace at a matchmaking shrine where a bald, ugly god materializes before him and assures him that he will find his destined girl in high school. The god explains that when soulmates meet, a sudden shock runs through their bodies, sparking instant attraction. The god then adds that what's more is that Rentarou is destined to meet a total of 100 soulmates. Fast forward a month after the meeting at the shrine, Rentarou begins his first year at Ohananamitsu High School. Lost in thought on his way to class, he suddenly bumps into Hanazono Hakari and Inda Karana, causing all three to tumble to the ground. As Rentarou collects himself and prepares to apologize, the trio lock eyes and a sudden electrifying sensation goes through their entire being. While the girls swiftly catch feelings, Rentarou is left wondering if these are two of the 100 soulmates the god had hinted at. However, not wanting to appear like a weirdo, the boy quickly picks himself up from the ground and offers a hand to the ladies. This is enough to fluster both girls, who blush at the gesture and start a subtle competition by pretending to have injured their legs from the fall in order to get his attention, eventually ending with both girls practically hanging onto him as they make their way to the nurse's office. Before the trio can arrive there, however, they overhear two students talking about a superstition native to the school. According to the rumors, anyone who finds a four-leaf clover in the field of flowers in the school's courtyard would get to date anyone they ask out. Hearing it has a 100% success rate, both girls rush off to find the clovers, leaving Rentarou behind. Later that evening after school, as Rentarou is heading home, he finds Hakari and Karana scouring through the field of flowers in the courtyard for a four-leaf clover. Figuring they must have been at it since school ended 4 hours ago, the boy decides to go get them something to drink. Upon his return, Rentarou finds only Karana still searching and asks if she found the four-leaf clover, to which she denies ever looking for. With Hakari nowhere in sight, Rentarou offers Karana one of the drinks. This surprises her and she blushes in embarrassment, but collects the drink and runs away. Just then, Hakari returns from the restroom and Rentarou offers her the second drink. The girl thanks him but asks if he could drink half first, explaining that she always has trouble finishing a whole can herself. As Rentarou hands her the remaining drink, he suddenly realizes her intention is an indirect kiss and accidentally spills the drink. In her frustration, the girl ends up blurting out that she loves Rentarou. However, before Rentarou can reply, Karana returns only to find the two holding hands, and she immediately accuses Hakari of cutting in line. This ends with the two girls confessing their feelings to Rentarou and asking who he chooses to be his girlfriend. Totally confused about who to choose, since he finds both girls equally attractive, the boy panics and runs off. Later that night, unsure of what to do, Rentarou heads to the shrine once again to seek guidance from the god of love. The god explains to Rentarou that it is impossible to choose between his soulmates because they have been built to be his ideal romantic partner. Normally, this would not be a problem for the average person as they only get one soulmate and might never even get to meet them. But in his case, the god made a mistake, so he now has to deal with it. The god then tells Rentarou that if someone were to meet their soulmate but things somehow didn't work out, all sorts of bad things would happen to them. So if he chooses between Hakari and Karana, the unchosen girl will be deleted from existence. On his way home, the boy realizes that if he rejects both girls tomorrow, he could secretly date each one without any issues. The following day at school, the two girls are waiting to hear Rentarou's answer. However, to their surprise, the boy arrives looking dirty and declares that he wants both of them to be his girlfriends. As it turns out, he had reconsidered his initial plan the day before. Having experienced rejection numerous times himself, Rentarou decided that no one deserved to go through that kind of pain. With his mind made up, Rentarou spent the entire night searching for four-leaf clovers to present to both girls and ask them to become his girlfriends. Touched by the romantic gesture and confessing that she's hopelessly in love with Rentarou and can't imagine herself anyone else, Hakari immediately accepts. Meanwhile, not wanting to be outdone, Karana quickly rushes to accept as well, and just like that, on only his second day, Rentarou finds himself with two girlfriends, with 98 more to go. The next day, the trio walks hand in hand in the school's hallway when suddenly a male student appears running and begging for his life. Hakari explains that the pursuer is none other than the vice principal, who is notorious for being extremely strict about school rules. If she sees a student running in the hallways, she'll chase them down until she catches them, and once she does, she'll initiate her infamous punishment. A French kiss. As the group witnesses the punishment, Hakari thinks about kisses, and she asks Rentarou if he has ever kissed anyone before. Karana's ears perk up at the question, and both girls eagerly await Rentarou's answer. When the boy admits he hasn't, as he's never had a girlfriend, both girls realize they have a chance to be his first kiss. That afternoon during recess, the trio heads to the rooftop for lunch. Both girls have prepared special lunches for Rentarou and offer him a taste. As usual, Hakari makes the first move, feeding him some egg rolls, which he declares are the best in the galaxy. Not wanting to be outdone, Karana hurriedly tries to feed him the cookies she made, but accidentally pokes him in the eye. Despite the mishap, once he finally tastes the cookies, he also proclaims them to be the best in the galaxy. And just like that, a simple lunch with Rentarou and his two girlfriends turns into an all-out contest as both girls compete to be his first kiss. First, Takari suggests feeding Rentarou a stick snack, but insists her hands are too dirty to hold it. So instead, she holds one end with her mouth and offers the other end to Rentarou. However, midway, the girl begins moving her mouth along the stick toward him. Seeing where this is heading, Karana decides to feed him too, but in her haste, she accidentally pokes him in the other eye, abruptly interrupting Hakari's intended kiss. With both of Rentarou's eyes irritated, Karana decides to take advantage of the situation, claiming Rentarou has a cold and attempts to kiss him to cure it. Before Karana can make her move, Hakari swiftly jumps in to confirm whether Rentarou truly has a cold. The girl explains that in her family, they check for colds by using their foreheads and lips, setting up for her own attempt at a kiss. And just as they're about to lock lips, Karana shoves her away from Rentarou and the two girls start bickering. This finally gets Rentarou suspicious, and it doesn't take long for him to realize what is going on. He explains that he had considered the possibility of this happening the previous night and cooked up a perfect plan which he shares with them. Rentarou explains that the two girls would stand in front of him, one to the right and the other to the left. The three would wear earphones blasting music at the highest volume and have blindfolds on. He would then walk randomly towards one girl decided by the roll of a dice, kiss her, then move towards the other and kiss her as well. When he is done, he will return to the starting point and message both girls to take off their blindfolds and earpieces. This way, no one would know who got the first kiss. Needless to say, the plan failed repeatedly, with each attempt ending in the most ridiculous ways imaginable, with Rentarou either finding himself in plot-filled positions with Hakari or getting pummeled by Karana. The ridiculous attempts continue until the trio is exhausted, and Karana declares that she knew the stupid plan was never going to work out, which sparks another argument between the two girls. Seeing his two soulmates fighting, Rentarou blames himself, believing it's all because he hasn't had his first kiss yet. Determined to resolve the issue, the boy runs from the roof with his two girlfriends following behind, surprised by his sudden reaction. Racing through the hallway, he puts his plan into action, shouting for the vice principal as he sprints down the corridor. As the girls grasp Rentarou's intention, the vice principal suddenly overtakes them, swiftly catching up to Rentarou and pinning him down, ready to administer her punishment. Karana intercepts her before she can act, and upon hearing Hakari saying that an inspector from the Board of Education is nearby, the vice principal retreats like a cockroach. The girls then ask why he'd do such a thing, and the boy explains that he didn't like seeing them fight. If his first kiss would cause such trouble, he'd rather throw it in the trash. Flustered by his response, the two girls confess that if Rentarou would throw his kiss away, they'd rather the other girl have it instead. Hearing this, Rentarou embraces them and comes up with a new plan. Back on the rooftop now, the boy explains that the three of them will kiss at once, so this way, all of them will share a first kiss. Both girls agree, and the three finally do what they should have done all along. The next day, the trio finds themselves in the library. Hakari explains that since Rentarou liked the egg rolls yesterday, she wants to learn how to cook more dishes for him. Karana chimes in, claiming she's there to learn about cooking as well, though she denies it's for Rentarou. Before long, the two start arguing again, but Rentarou steps in, teasing them to play nice by reminding them they already shared a kiss, which leaves the girls flustered. The boy then walks over to a shelf to find something to read, and his attention is drawn to a book titled Love, Taiyaki, and Me. As he reaches for it, he discovers that another hand is also reaching for the same book. Turning to see who it belongs to, he finds an extremely petite girl looking up at him, and as their eyes meet, a spark immediately goes through their entire being. Before Rentarou can get a better look at her, the petite girl, still blushing, begins to back away, surrendering the book they had both been reaching for earlier. Rentarou stops her after just a few steps and offers her the book instead, saying she can have it if she wants. Shizuka pauses, considering his offer for a moment, and she then points at a seemingly random page of the book she is holding. Rentarou reads the line in confusion, but then notices an armband on her shoulder indicating she's a librarian and asks if that's what she meant. In response, the girl flips to a seemingly random page in her book and points to another line saying that he had hit the bull's eye. This leads him to the conclusion that there is a no-speaking rule in the library which he had been unknowingly breaking. As if to solidify the point, Shizuka flips to another page and points out a few more lines for Rentarou to read, questioning what brings him here. Not wanting to break the no-speaking rule, Rentarou decides to respond with gestures and points to a book on the shelf to indicate that he's looking for a book. He then makes a square shape with his palms to show it's a novel and a laughing gesture to indicate that it's funny. However, his gesticulations are interrupted when Shizuka points to a line questioning why he isn't speaking. Realizing it's not because of a library rule, Rentarou asks her the same question. This makes Shizuka a little embarrassed, and she quickly flips to a new page, pointing to a line that explains she has always found conversing with people difficult. The girl then points to another line that says she'll go get someone else and starts to run off. Rentarou quickly stops her, apologizing for not realizing, and asks if she'd still like to help him. Shizuka nods in agreement, and Rentarou properly explains that he's looking for romance novels. He asks if Shizuka has any recommendations, and the girl brightens up at the request as she rushes off to get him some books. Shizuka returns shortly with a stack of books, but the head librarian informs them that Rentarou can't borrow any books until he gets his library card, which will take about a week. Determined to help, Shizuka offers him her own book instead, and Rentarou gratefully accepts. The two then formally introduce themselves, and to Rentarou's surprise, he discovers that Shizuka is actually one of his classmates. That night, Rentarou spends most of his time reading the novel he had received from Shizuka. The story revolves around a knight assigned to protect a princess. Despite their duties, the two fall deeply in love, but the princess is bound to fulfill her duty by marrying into an allied royal family. At the end of the novel, the knight asks if there is any way they could defy their fate, and this question gets Rentarou thinking. Is there any way they can escape the fate that awaits soulmates who don't end up together? The next morning, Rentarou returns Shizuka's novel to her and is pleasantly surprised to find that she has brought the second book in the series for him. The boy asks if he can borrow it, and she simply responds by handing him the second book, which he exchanges for the first. Feeling it would be unfair not to do anything for Shizuka in return, Rentarou decides to get her a drink, and the two have a brief conversation. The boy explains how much he loved the story and points out how Shizuka seems to know exactly which parts of the book fit every random situation. Timidly, the girl explains that she loves the book and that has indeed read the text repeatedly. Using the book again, she explains that her shyness makes her more comfortable communicating through books rather than speaking, which has made it hard for her to make friends. Noticing the sadness in her eyes, Rentarou decides to keep the book a little longer and return it to her later, to which she agrees. A few days later, Shizuka is walking down a corridor when she spots Rentarou on a bench in the courtyard, chatting with Hakari and Karana. Seeing how close he is with the two girls, she assumes he hasn't gotten back to her because he's been too busy with his girlfriends to read the book. Feeling dejected, she returns to class and is about to pack her bags and head home when Rentarou walks in. The boy explains he's glad to see her and wants to repay her kindness. Rentarou then shares a mobile app with an ebook version of the book she had lent him and asks her to click on any line from the ebook. And when she does, the app reads the selected text aloud. He explains that he manually typed the entire novel and created a text-to-speech program specifically to make it easier for her to communicate in a way that's comfortable for her. This gesture deeply moves Shizuka, leading her to use the app to confess her love for Rentarou, to which he reciprocates, and the two share a heartfelt hug. Later that evening, Rentarou brings Shizuka to meet his two girlfriends and timidly asks for their permission to have her as his third girlfriend. Karana initially reacts with anger, but Hakari steps in praising Rentarou for his care and loyalty to both of them despite his new feelings for Shizuka. Moved by Hakari's words, Karana relents, and Rentarou reassures them both that his love for them will only grow stronger. And with that, Rentarou finds himself with his third soulmate, expanding what is now becoming a quickly growing, hilariously dysfunctional entourage. Thank you for watching, like and subscribe for more videos like this.